In this video, we will show how to integrate a template in the framework Symfony 4. Here we have two templates, one for the front office and another one for the back office. Once downloaded and decompressed, we can see here that both templates have basically the same architecture. They are composed by the folders, CSS, images, JavaScript, and libraries. Also, as shown here, they contain the files about contact, index, services, which refer to different web pages. By navigating between different pages, we can see here that all pages, for example, about, contact, they share common elements like the header and the footer. Here we can see in the resume page it contains the same header and the same footer. Regarding the back office template, if we navigate between different pages, we can see here that here in the index page, here we are in the chart page, they share the same sidebar. If we go deeper in the code source details, we can see here for the nav menu in the contact page, it is the same code. So every time we have to do copy paste of the repeated header or repeated footer from one page to another, this would be exhausting. A way to resolve this problem is to use the inheritance provided by Twig in Symfony. Template inheritance allows us to produce a base template that consists of all common elements of your web pages as blocks. Then every web page can extend the base layout and override any of the defined blocks. Let's start by building our base front and base back files. Here under the folder template, we will create a new file. One base file for the front, we will name it base front.html.twig. After creating the two files, base front and base back, now we will open the index file of each template, then move its content to base front file. The same thing that we will do for the back office template. Here we have the back baseback.html twig and the basefront.html.twig. Now the next step is to move the related CSS, JavaScript, and images under our project. As known, CSS files, JavaScript, and picture should be included in the folder public. That's what we will do. Now be careful here. We could have two folders, CSS, JavaScript, and images for each template, which will make us confused. So for better organization of our project, we will create two folders here, one for the front office and another one for the back office. Now we will move the related files of each template. According to that, make sure that all files path are in accordance with file location. For example, here we have to add for the base front the name of the folder. Also, we have to use the twig function asset. Same thing we will do for all the CSS files, JavaScript files, and for all the images. As well as these steps, we have to define the blocks in the base front or base back that can be changed dynamically in the child template. In our case, two block area are defined, the title and the body. Each block may be overrided by a child template if it is redefined, else it will be left with its default content. Here, for example, we will define the block title. In our case, we have title, esprit, template, and index. Here we will define the block title for the word index only. We will keep esprit template constant. Now here we will define the block title, name of the block title. Then we will define here end block. Now we will define the next block that can be changed from one page to another page, which is the content. Here, the header, then we have, so here, it is named, for example, in our case, hero section. So after the tag section, we will define our block. Block body. Okay, then before the closing tag section, we will close the tag body and block. Okay, the same step that we will do for the back. If we refresh the web page in our browser here, you see nothing has changed. We must tell every page here to extend the base file. So here we have to add extends the name of the file. For example, we will extend from the base front .html .twig. After adding the extent to this page, we will refresh the page. Here we get this error. A template that extends another one cannot include content outside twig blocks. Did you forget to put the content inside the block? So here we forget to have put the content of our page inside a block. Now here, this is the content of all our page. Now we have to add the blocks. We already named the blocks block body. Here we will redefine it. We will write the block body, and at the end of this page we will put end block. Now, if we refresh our page, okay, here we get our template, our front template is well integrated. Now we can change the extend space back. We will change it to the back now, and we will refresh our page. Now the back end template is well integrated. Now we will go more in depth and explore the block title. For example, here we can see that Esprit admin dashboard, it is the same title as the base file. So here we will define the block title. Block title and block. If we will not redefine the block, it will keep the same value. If we define it, for example, here we will add student. We will redefine the title by add student. If we refresh it, so the word Esprit admin will be kept and the word dashboard is changed by add student. The same thing that we can do in the front office template. And finally, you find here the GitHub link of our project.